Hey Sky Girls, welcome to another exciting episode of Stay True powered by Sky Girl Z.
My name is Abigail.
I'm Alexandra.
And I'm Tendai.
So today in this episode, we have a lot of exciting content lined up for you.
Coming up, we have a skincare routine on Skin Deep. The girls and I discuss girl code on Real Talk. One of our Sky sisters shares with us why she took the pledge. And later, we go out into the community to play some games on Game Time. Then Chichi comes through in Celeb Tries.
Right about now, let's check out how we can take care of our skin in Skin Deep.
Hi Sky Girls, I'm Leona and I'm here at Serenity Day Spa for my facial and I'm taking you along with me, so let's go.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks. I'm here for my appointment at 11, facial clearance.
Okay, kindly give me your name.
Leona.
So what we're going to do first is we're going to take out the makeup.
Okay.
We'll take out the makeup and then we do a cleanse and then we do an exfoliation. We do an extraction while I'm doing the steam together. And then after that, we'll do a massage. And then we're going to do now the cream in the end. Okay? So this is a milk cleanser. It's normally good for the skin. It doesn't dry out the skin at all. So you might feel a little bit of some kind of sensitivity, but otherwise it's nothing to worry about. So regime in a house, in a home, like when you're at home, it should be just like you have a normal cleanser. And maybe if need be, you can have a toner, an exfoliator and a day cream. That's all you need that helps you to lighten the skin. Okay, so now we're going to do the steam. And then we're going to do together with extractions. Extractions are taking out whitehead and blackhead. So this normally is just done for 5 minutes and then we'll continue with the extractions. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do a massage. Then after that, we're going to do the mask. We're going to do two masks. We'll do one for the hydrating and then we'll use one for the super restorative. This one is a super restorative mask. It helps with the tightening of the skin. Doing that, I'm going to ask you what kind of massage you would like for the 10 minutes. Would you like a hand massage? Would you like a neck massage or foot massage? It's totally up to you to choose which one you prefer. Hands?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the 10 minutes is up. I'll be taking off the mask now. Okay, so when we're done with the facial today, you only wash your face until after 6 hours so that all the products that I put on your face will take a good effect. If you wash your face too quickly, then everything will be restored. So we're going to start with the hydrating facial since we did the hydrating lotion, since we did the hydrating facial. And we're going to add the sunscreen because your face now is sensitive. So we're going to add the sunscreen so that when you're in the sun, you don't burn. Okay, so the facial is done. Thank you so much for coming. Hope to see you next month.
Hey guys,
Oh my goodness, that feels so relaxing. It feels so great. I feel 10 years younger. And I advise you to get your skincare done at least once in a couple of months. Yeah? So remember to follow us on all social media platforms at SkyGirlZ. Thank you and bye.
Now we check out the girls and I talk about girl code on Real Talk.
Hi, hello and welcome to Real Talk. Hello, ladies. Guess what? Today we have an interesting topic. We're talking about girl code.
Okay, so one of our Sky sisters sent in a question and she wants to know what we think about girl code and what are a few examples according to us.
Okay, interesting.
Okay, so people talk about boy code.
Yeah.
Girls don't have girl code.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, if you're a girl, mm-hmm. no one has to spell it out for you to be okay to have a girl
code. Yeah, 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 yeah.
So, yeah, I'm going to get right into it.
Mm-hmm.
Girl code. For me, I personally think if you're my friend, mm-hmm. you don't have to be friends with my boyfriend.
True.
Yeah, that's your girl code. Yeah. Because why would you want to be friends with my boyfriend?
Wait, what if I was his friend
before you guys started dating?
I mean, it's different. Okay, if you...
Yeah.
Yes.
No.
I would be okay with my boyfriend having a friend.
Not really best friend. It's even friendship. But I feel like, according to what you've asked, I feel like, okay, yes, you can be friends. You can be like, hey, hello. Because you're friends before. You can be talking, still having the same thing, but personally you just have to know, okay, this person is no longer just a friend to me, but he's also my friend's boyfriend. You get my point? So, I mean, there's a limit. You can't spend 10 hours or the whole day together. That doesn't work like that. If you guys used to do that, you can't do it anymore because, you know, okay, there's a limit. There's restriction to the friendship now. Yeah.
Think about it like this, like, I understand that girl code is like about supporting each other and respecting each other and literally just being there for each other, you know? In my mind, girl code is just us supporting each other as girls, you know?
Okay, I don't really have a lot of friends. I only have one friend and she's my best friend. So then, like, every time someone does something wrong to her, I'm always there. So it always, like, comes to me. Whenever she's affected, I'm also affected. So it's like,
okay, it's a two-way thing.
She did this and this to me and this and this. So yeah.
Okay, so for me, what I would say is that, okay, girl code, as you said, it's a lifestyle. So it's not just, okay, if you do this, you do that. Because it's not only among his friends. So it can be with a fellow girl, anybody else, so long they're a girl, you know what I'm saying? Because it's a lifestyle. We don't have to have, like, a specific relationship. And like for what you said in terms of you saying, okay, so if I hate somebody, then you have to hate them as well. It really doesn't. It depends with the level of friendship that you guys have. Like, you know what I'm saying? And the level of friendship that you have with the person that they don't like. There's a limit to how you can hang out with them. You get my point? It is very important to stand up for one another as ladies. You know what I'm saying? Hey? For example, if a girl has like an uncool boyfriend who's making her do things that are not making her stay true to herself, like making her smoke and do all these things that are just not cool for her. You know what I'm saying? So it's very important as ladies to come in and, you know, support her in the sense that you can advise her, to tell her to say, okay, this is not right. In short, you open up her eyes to the reality and make her realize to say, this is not cool. This is actually what's cool. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And it's not only that, we have to share. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I think this point is normally not highlighted much. We have to share as ladies. Girl code, you need to share. If you know, okay, your friend can't really afford certain things and stuff like that, you need to share sanitary pads, stuff like sanitary pads. Yeah.
Okay, guys, that's all we have to say about girl codes. I'm sure we learned much, right?
Oh, yes.
So if you want to share your views with us, make sure you visit us on our social media platforms at SkyGirlZ.
Bye.
Okay, cool. So girl code is all about supporting each other and being there for each other, right? So next up, we check out Josephine, and she tells us why she took the pledge.
Thank you. Hi Sky Girls, my name is Josephine Chayu. I'm 16 years old. I'm in grade 12 at Mary Queen of Peace. I pledge to be true to myself and what I believe in. I will trust my choices and I will not let anyone else determine who I am. Baking is my thing and smoking is not my thing. I will make choices according to my character. I will rise to meet my sky. Being part of Sky, I learned to say no to things I don't want in my life, like smoking. I like the community of Sky because we are all about positive vibes and everything about Sky is cool. I want to be successful and I don't want to be a failure. I can say no to things I don't want to do, even if everyone is doing them. I find it easy to express how I feel to other people. I find it easy to handle problems in my life.
Just as we've heard from Josephine, after she joined the Sky Girls community, she learned how to say no to things that are not her things. Like, you know what I'm saying? And guys, did you see how delicious those cupcakes looked? Oh my God! You know me, food is my thing.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So if you guys also want to join the Sky community, be sure to take the pledge just like Jocelyn did.
Taking the pledge helps you know what you want and what you don't want.
Exactly.
And what you want to achieve. Now the boys and band squad and I went out in the community to play some traditional games on Game Time. Let's check it out.
Hey Sky Girls, welcome to Game Time. I'm your host, Abigail Nkoma. So we are in the community to play a very awesome game called Dodgeball, but popularly known as Washombawaloa. So in this game, we've got two teams. The other team is throwing the ball and the other team is inside dodging the ball. So we get to see which team has got more members at the end of 10 minutes. Let's get into it.
This game, we started playing it when we were pretty young.
Yeah.
Our friends. And we've just grown up with it, and it's a very nice game. It's very fun.
I couldn't see the ball coming. I just looked somewhere else, and then all of a sudden, I look forward, and boom, I got hit. You can do it!
You can do it, Rebecca!
Hey!
Rebecca currently is holding us down and we hope she'll keep it together. We hope she'll keep it cool. Yeah, she's going to make it.
Oh! Well, I'm not sure who's gonna last the longest, but as soon as I heard that we just have to catch and dodge, I felt like it was a much simpler.
Everything became simpler.
Yeah.
I honestly feel like we're gonna all go far in this.
Yeah. But we'll win. We'll win.
Definitely.
We'll win.
Definitely.
I don't know who's gonna go first, but we'll win. I just didn't expect him to do that. I was just like, ooh, Matrix, like.
Last person, it's pressure because the people that are here throwing on each side, they've come with They come with strength.
Yeah.
The way we born, I wasn't expecting this, but come out it was.
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. I think we were, I knew we were going to win from the start, you know? Every team I'm on just seems to win.
Wow.
Wow.
It was so much fun. Yeah.
Wow, that was interesting, guys.
It was.
But have you guys realized that it's actually rare to see boys playing such games?
It is.
But they actually won. They beat the girls.
Really?
You know what I think? I think the boys beat you at your own game because you didn't take 10 dice.
Exactly.
Okay, no worries, you're gonna come with me next time.
Really?
But it was a very great experience because like I got to have fun after such a long time because it's been long since I played that game.
Nice.
But though the boys beat us, just like you're saying, I still got to have fun.
Okay, cool. So next up we have Chichi Daisy stepping out of her comfort zone in Celebrity Tries.
Hi girls, I am Chichi Daisy, radio host, TV presenter slash producer, and also an actress. And I am with my good friend here, Josiah, aka Kalimba. Africa?
Karanji.
Kala! Yeah. Oh my God, sorry. Yeah, so today I've been dared to do to take part in the Celebrity Tries, and I'm ecstatic. I can't wait to see what's gonna happen. As you can see, kudivipyangwa, and my good friend here is gonna train me on how to go about it. So, nifishinde chitanomba.
Ifipyangwa ifinara mpira. Mwala ingira mumushumu.
Aha.
Eh, mwala senda fumes. Kutwika, mwatwika pamutu.
Pamutu.
Mwapange ngana.
So it's like a ritual and wholesale at the same time. Okay, all right. Okay, so let's do this. Begin.
Make sure people. Because I want to combo into a test.
Serious, eh? Okay. First of all, there was the first part of making sure that I create a proper wrapper so I can put the vipiangos on my head. And then second part, I think, you know, when we're growing up, you'd always hear these men or women calling out, banja, piango, piango. But then, I don't know whether I should start calling the piango or I don't know. I'm just confused. Piango, piango. Five kwacha, piango. Piango, piango, piango. Five kwacha, piango. The fact that my hands were getting tired, but thank God I had balance. And also just people not buying. I think it's really frustrating because you want to leave the house with your piangos and you want to come back with your money, not with your piangos. Five kwacha piango. Five kwacha, I'm so good. Five kwacha. Ah. Over. Ah, la, 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 la. Hey. What's up, Buno, baby? Ziko, mo, baby. Five kwacha, spiango, five kwacha. Five kwacha.
Five
kwacha. Ah, well, the person facing that. What do you put in? Ah, the person that. And because I'm the face. What about your chinja? Chinja, chinja, chinja. I can't get punja away when I go. Five kwacha, spiango, kun. Eh, I need to change you. Eh, tengan punch, spiango, shimon. Ziko. Yeah. See, I'm just nailing this. I'm good at this. In fact, I think I misplaced. I need to start shipyango business. Am I so good? Ah, lekani ni buera. Am I so good? Am I so good?
How
did you buino?
Today, I think I had a lot of realization about the processes of the small things, that the elements that make one thing come to life. And I think having these vipiangos in our homes, we need to appreciate the people that pick these one by one to put them together. You can imagine the thickness and the length and the width of this thing. It's a lot. You put them together, where do they get these rubbers? You know, so I'm just so grateful. Right now, I'm having a grateful heart, and I think I really appreciate these people for what they do. Chichi Daisy is my name. My thing is TV, radio, and acting. And things that I don't like to do, I don't like being in the club. I don't like watching soccer. And most definitely, I don't like smoking.
Wow, guys, I think she did a very great job. Though I didn't expect a celebrity like her to do such a great job in the community. I mean, I love the way she coped with the people, the way she just put herself out there, you know? Yeah.
I think it looked pretty easy. Oh my God. She did good, but I think she...
Okay, you know what? Okay, you try. You try and say, Vipiango, the way she was doing it, try doing it. It was easy, eh? Come on, girl.
What was she saying?
Vipiango.
Vipiango.
No, say it the way she was saying it.
Say it the way she was saying it. This is it.
Uh-huh.
What was she saying? My five kwacha?
Oh, please, you know what? Anyways, looks like she had fun and she actually managed to do it. We have come to the end of today's episode. I hope you enjoyed yourself just as we did. Always remember to stay true to yourself. See you next time.
Myself and what I believe in. I will trust my choices and I will not let anyone else determine who I am. Success, making friends and dancing, that's my thing. Jealousy, gossip and smoking, that's not my thing. I will make choices according to my character. I will rise to meet my sky. Nothing will get in my way.